This is Module 3 of the North Carolina Department of Transportation Erosion and Sediment Control Certification Training, covering regulatory requirements. The instructor is Rich McLaughlin, professor in the Department of Crop and Soil Sciences at North Carolina State University. There are four primary agencies which are involved in protecting our natural resources, not including the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency. Within the North Carolina Department of Environmental Quality, there are three divisions with different areas of jurisdiction. There's energy, mineral, and land resources. There's water resources. And there's a division of coastal management. In addition, the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, often just referred to as the Corps, has federal jurisdiction over all surface waters. We'll discuss each of these agencies' interests as they relate to construction of highways in just a minute. In most states, the Clean Water Act of 1972 directed them to establish a law protecting surface waters from sediment. In North Carolina, this was the Sedimentation Pollution Control Act of 1973. It gave authority to the Department of Environmental Quality to enforce the five mandatory standards of the Act. First, an erosion and sediment control plan had to be developed. Second, the land disturbing activity must follow that plan. Third, the buffer zones are required around all waters. Fourth, cut and fill slopes have to be geotechnically stable, that is, they won't collapse on their own. And finally, a ground cover has to be established within 21 days. Note that this part of the Act has been overridden by a federal non-point discharge elimination system permit, or NPDS, which requires a ground cover to be established within 7 to 14 days. This will be covered under our ground cover section. Also note that farming and forestry activities are not included as part of this program. The Division of Energy, Mineral, and Land Resources is in charge of enforcing the Sedimentation Pollution Control Act. This includes inspecting any land disturbing projects at any time. They can issue a Notice of Violation, or NOV, if the project is not following the plan or is otherwise not in compliance with the Sedimentation Pollution Control Act. They are also tasked with enforcing the NPDES stormwater rules. If a project does not comply with the plan or the rules, civil penalties of up to $5,000 can be issued per day per violation. So for example, if a silt fence is not functioning and a sediment basin is full of sediment and needs maintenance, that would be two $5,000 fines per day that would go by every day that they were not corrected. Finally, criminal penalties can be assessed if these other measures do not bring compliance. Ultimately, the state can issue a stop work order, which shuts down the project until all problems are resolved. So, here's a question. How many NOVs can my project receive before my certification may be suspended or revoked? This is from our first module. Hopefully everybody remembers, one from any agency may result in certification being revoked. The Division of Water Resources is focused on water resources of the state. If your project is affecting water resources, you will have to obtain a 401 permit to do the work. This is also required in riparian buffers, which we'll discuss in a minute. They can visit your project at any time. Normally, this is only happening when there's a complaint about water quality from a citizen. And they can also issue notices of violation. There are 20 counties in North Carolina which have some part of them adjacent to coastal waters. In these counties, the Division of Coastal Management has jurisdiction over these waters. Like the Division of Water Resources, They can inspect a DOT project and issue NOVs if compliance issues are found. The federal agency most involved in DOT projects is the Army Corps of Engineers. They have jurisdiction over all surface waters of the United States, and a permit from them is needed for any activities in those waters. They can inspect projects at any time and issue their own version of a notice of violation, which they call a cease and desist order, which stops all work until compliance is achieved. Within the DOT, there is the Roadside Environmental Field Operation Unit, which handles the Erosion and Sediment Control Program. This authority was given to it from the Department of Environmental Quality. This involves enforcing rules under the Sedimentation Pollution Control Act, or SPCA, as well as the MPDES permit. This involves monitoring as well as finding solutions to problems as they arise. So the Roadside Environmental Unit has a number of ways to handle different situations on a project. Initially, they can issue an immediate corrective action order, meaning within 24 hours, the problem needs to be fixed. For large problems that may take longer, they can issue extensions of those, as you see in ICA extension 1, extension 2, etc. For more serious problems, they may have to issue a stop work order, which you see here. That means all work has to be suspended until the problem is resolved. If there's a problem in an environmentally sensitive area for which permits are needed, then a permit consultation needed is issued, and agencies involved in that particular area will be contacted. If there's a problem with the plan itself, then there may be an ECPAR or a plan audit request that is issued to get a new plan that answers the questions that have come up. Here's a quiz. So my project received an ICA today. Who would have been the one with the authority to issue those? Department of Environmental Quality, Resident Engineer, Roadside Environmental Unit, or Army Corps of Engineers? Well, remember, an ICA is internal to DOT, so they're the only ones that would be issuing a ICA or immediate compliance. So to summarize, you should pay careful attention to erosion and sediment control plans and any notes and permits shown there. Ask questions if you don't think you understand something. In general, be proactive and let people know if there might be a problem. We expect all parties on the construction of roads, bridges, and highways to work together to protect our natural resources. This is the end of this module.